Hey everybody, it is June 8th, 2012, the weekly wrap-up, and we're continuing on with the intermediate voice course, just a couple of exercises there, but one of them is really cool. I call it a nay-nay with a slide, and that particular exercise, if you've been doing the exercises up to this point in the intermediate voice course, is a great exercise to start to really see if you have strength and ability. It builds strength and flexibility in your range. And so I'm always happy when I get students to that actual point of the course, because I know, and if they're doing the right things when I listen to them perform this exercise, I know that they're now getting a lot closer to understanding in a physical way what mix is all about and how to move from their chest and their mix back and forth, how to challenge it, how to bring it up higher and lower between their first and second bridges. So anyway, that's one of the things that we did. Another thing that we're working on now is the Listen and Recognize course. And on that course, we've evolved as well, because this week was the first week where you're now back identifying major and minor thirds, but also now I'm starting to incorporate passing tones, notes outside the key. So the tonality sets your ear up really strong. And then when you bring one note in, and that's how we start this, and the note's F sharp actually, you start to hear that F sharp like you've never heard it before. And it just sort of really gets programmed into your ears, so it's a lot easier to remember what F sharp sounds like and hear it and really have an ear for it. So again, same thing, if you've been progressing through these courses and following them, by now, you should have way better ears and way better concepts for pitch, way better concepts for being able to sing harmonies, and your voice should be in a lot better condition to actually go from the chest up into your mix, up into your head, back down through your mix, down into your head, down into your chest, pardon me. So I'm also explaining this as if you are a regular member on the site and that you have full access to these courses. Now, if you don't have full access to these courses, you have choices now. You can go ahead and get access just to any one of these courses, the Intermediate Voice course, or you can get access to the Listen and Recognize course, or you can get full access for any length or period of time that you so choose. So, if you're not a regular member of the site and some of this sounds interesting to you, and I hope that it does, definitely check it out. So what else? What else is we're also still releasing the song breakdowns, portions of the song breakdowns, as well as new songs that are about to come up pretty soon. I've got some great new singers on the site that I'm sure you're going to love, and we're going to do song breakdowns with them, and that's always tons of fun to do. So there's that. So before I wrap this up on one topic different from anything else that I covered here, I just want to talk about practicing. You know, I've spent my life asking my students to practice. You know, practice this. I'll say it at the end of this wrap-up. Keep practicing. But you know, practice should not be something like you're in school and it's a course that you have to hurry up and finish and get it done and then get it turned in. Music isn't like that. Music is something that's nourishing. And the more you do it, the better at it you get. And the better at it you get, the more enjoyable it really is. So for me, practicing has never been a drudgery. I've actually always enjoyed practicing, meaning that I pick up a guitar and I play it. I don't even feel like I'm practicing anymore. Others would think that's what I'm doing. But I'm playing it for the enjoyment. I've gotten that far into it. And the same thing for singing. I sing songs for pure enjoyment. I walk around singing a song, I'm driving around in my car, I'm singing songs, or I'm thinking of notes and pulling up an F sharp out of nowhere just for the fun of it, listening to something on a recording and going, what key is that in? That's just natural for me. That's what I'm trying to bring to the site, is all of these things that are actual joy and natural for me, to incorporate that into you so it becomes joy and natural for you. Anyway, you have to practice a bit to make that happen, but you don't have to kill yourself. You know, I've got these audio downloads that I'm always giving with the courses, so you can take these audio downloads, You can kick back in the listen and recognize, like I always say, find a nice quiet spot, your room or a couch somewhere, put some headphones on, close your eyes, and just listen to the listen and recognize course and go through it and practice it and have fun with it. Do it that way. On the vocalese exercises, you can incorporate them and burn them on a CD and go ahead and get in your car and drive around, and on your way from one spot to another, pop in one of those vocal exercises and vocalize a little bit. Naturally bring it in as part of your day. Doing that is way better than deciding that one day you're just going to be all gung-ho about it and spend 3 hours practicing and then not touching it again for three days, 4 days, 5 days, a week. Now, I know sometimes our time doesn't allow us to do these types of things. That's why I'm trying to give you some ideas for just sort of incorporating it in those moments where you really do have the time to do it. And the more you do it, the more you'll enjoy it. And the more you enjoy it, the more you'll want to do it. Anyway, that's the wrap-up. Keep practicing. I'll see you next time.